Aristotle said plot comes first. Here's mine. Go to med school, move to LA, snag the perfect guy, Jerry.
I can't explain. He's a new client.
But sometimes life doesn't stick to the plot. My mother died. I returned home to be with my grieving father.
I understand what you're going through. There's nothing worse than losing a lifelong companion.
Sid Hansen. It's me, Kyle Moran. Homeroom, South Providence High.
And surprise, I rediscovered my high school fantasy. Mom always liked him.
And you've got the hots for a chauffeur.
Mom.
Pool man wasn't available.
Mother.
I got here as fast as I could. What's going on?
Emergency, they need you to assist in surgery.
Well, I need to scrub.
There's no time for that.
What? There's two patients. It must be a transplant. Who's smoking in the OR?
Hello, dear. I got bored being dead, so I thought I'd dabble.
You're the surgeon?
Yes, and you are going to love this operation. I'm about to remove some of the positive qualities of your ex-boyfriend, Jerry, and implant them in your new boyfriend, Kyle.
You gotta be dreaming.
No, dear, you are. See, Kyle is charming and funny and kind, but he lacks Jerry's ambition. I want to even things out. Shall we begin? I need a 10 blade. Get ready with cautery.
This is crazy, Sid. Don't let her do it. You can't go around changing people's personalities. You gotta accept them for who they are.
He's right. Besides, you can't put the ambition of a Hollywood agent into the body of a limo driver. It'll kill him.
I think it's worth the risk. But if Sid doesn't want me to proceed, I won't. Sid?
Knock him out.
Okie dokie. Now, the first incision goes here. What's happened?
He must have severed an artery.
Oh, is that bad?
It's terrible. There's no pulse. Oh, no, not Kyle, too.
I didn't even touch this one.
Oh, he must have had an allergic reaction to the anesthesia.
Sid, Jerry's crashing.
Give me an amp of epi.
I'll have a diet soda.
Clear! Kyle? Kyle? Come on, Kyle! Kyle! Oh, Mother, what have you done? I'm gonna lose them. I'm gonna lose them both.
What's all that screaming about?
I was giving a shot to Hannah, and Joni didn't take it very well.
What a baby.
You know, I was thinking since it's Friday, maybe after work, I'll stop by the bar and have a drink with you.
Great. It's Shooters for Hooters night. I'm kidding. Hey, aren't you supposed to go out with Jerry tonight?
I don't think so. He lives in California, remember?
Yeah, but he called Tuesday to say that he was coming into town and that you should leave Friday night open.
Jerry's coming to Providence?
Is that a problem?
Huge problem. I don't want to see him.
Why not?
Because I don't want to see him.
Why not?
I'm not telling you.
Oh, come on. You don't trust me?
No, I don't. It's just, it's really embarrassing, okay?
So? I'm not the judgmental one.
All right.
I don't want to see Jerry because the last time I saw him, he was in the shower with another man.
She said that's the difference between you and me. If I caught my girlfriend in the shower with another girl, I'd just jump right in.
Well, maybe that explains why you don't have a girlfriend.
Sid.
Joni.
You have to help me. Hannah is sick.
Well, what's wrong?
She's running a fever.
And?
And she's running a fever. What more do you need? Mm-hmm. As soon as it hit 100, I threw her in the car.
100. That's all? Let me just check her leg. There's no redness. Has she been excessively fussy?
No.
Vomiting?
No.
Then calm down, Joni. I told you that Hannah might have a mild reaction to the DPT shot.
Mild? Sid, she's burning up.
Well, if she's uncomfortable, give her ibuprofen. Otherwise, just let the fever run its course.
Wait, how do I know if she's uncomfortable?
Joni, you're the mom. You'll know. Look, I have other patients. I'm sorry. I've got to run.
Sid, please don't leave. I have questions.
Go.
Didn't you take an oath?
Hi, I'm Dr. Sid Hansen.
Yeah, it's about time.
You hear that moan? Christopher's been up all night doing that.
Well, why don't you take Christopher's shirt off for me and we'll take a look. When did he last eat?
8 hours ago, but he's never been a big eater.
Hi, sweetheart. I'm gonna check your ears here for you. Okay. There we go.
Looks good.
Let me see your mouth, huh? Suck is a little weak. Hey, look at those pudgy hands. Has he been pulling his legs up?
Some.
That usually indicates abdominal discomfort. What I'd like to do is get an x-ray on his belly and his lungs and check his blood and urine.
Is it serious?
We'll know more after the test.
So the dog and the cat and the parrot weren't enough.
I guess you think I've gone completely overboard.
No, I'm probably the one person in the world who doesn't.
That's true. We both love animals. I guess that's one of many things we have in common.
Well, let's see the patient. Oh, my. What's his name?
Timmy.
And what seems to be the problem with Timmy?
Well, I think he's depressed. He won't come out of his shell, not even for fresh tomatoes.
Oh. I'll tell you what, I think I know what's going on, but let me double check with the text.
Well, we've certainly been seeing a lot of each other lately, haven't we, Dr. Hansen?
You can thank your dog's worms for that.
Well, ever since my husband died, my animals have been a real comfort to me. Mm. I suppose it's been the same for you ever since your wife passed away.
Here we go. When hibernation begins, most tortoises stop eating. It is not uncommon for the desert tortoise to hibernate for up to 6 months a year. So you can relax, Ms. Blake. You have a dull pet, not a sick one.
What do I do now?
Just change his water once a week. If he's not out by April, I'll want to see you again.
Well, I certainly hope to see you before then. I mean, we can't stay in our shells forever, can we, Dr. Hansen?
No signs of pneumonia, no intestinal obstruction. Am I missing something?
Not that I see.
What's going on with this baby? He has an elevated white count, but no obvious signs of infection. Should I be thinking spinal tap?
I would. You want me to assist?
Yeah, I'd like that.
No problem. But remember the hardest part about giving a baby a spinal tap.
What?
Telling the parents.
On my baby? No way.
We need to rule out meningitis. If left undetected, it could lead to deafness and retardation.
But couldn't a spinal tap paralyze him?
It's a very safe procedure. It's no worse than drawing blood.
Which you've done. And you've catheterized him and poked him and prodded him. And we're still no closer to knowing what's wrong with him.
I understand your anxiety, Mr. Kosowski, but children can't give us a lot of information. So unfortunately, diagnosing them becomes a process of elimination.
I want a second opinion.
Fine, I'll see if Dr. Reynolds is available.
Well, is that the other woman? No, I'd like to speak to a male doctor if I could.
Dr. Reynolds is a highly trained physician. Would you like to go on with the procedure?
Yes.
Wow, looks like somebody spent more on a bunch of flowers than most of our patients earn in a week.
That's disgusting. That's Jerry.
Sydney, surprise! You can pick your jaw up off the ground. Here, I brought you some flowers.
Thanks. Annika, could you give these to the patients, please?
Oh, I'd be happy to.
What a lovely gesture. So, this is Providence.
What are you doing here, Jerry?
Oh, I had to go see a playwright over at Brown, and I figured it was a good excuse to come see you. And your new setting. I love the whole Ave Maria theme.
Look, Jerry, I'm really busy. I have a patient that needs a spinal tap. What do you want?
To have dinner with you tonight.
I don't think that would be a good idea. Look, Jerry, I have no intention of pursuing this relationship.
Who's talking about a relationship? Come on, I'm talking about dinner. I know things didn't work out between us, but there's no reason that we can't be friends. Please? I am not leaving this clinic until you say yes.
Okay, fine.
Great! What's the best restaurant in Providence? Somewhere in Boston?
Look, let's make it simple. There's a restaurant down the street called the River Club.
All right, I'll meet you there at 7. Oh, and I sent a gift over to your house. Wear it, don't wear it. Either way, I want you to have it. Oh, excuse me.
Hi. Busy day for you.
Hey.
Did we have a lunch date or something?
No, something's come up and we need to talk. You got time for a walk?
No, actually, I don't. Why, what's up?
Well, it's kind of personal.
Do you need me to examine something?
No. No, look, we can't discuss this in the clinic. I'll come by your house later and we'll talk about it then.
Kyle, you can give me a little hint.
Okay. It's a major decision that could change both of our lives forever.
Yeah, well, that can wait.
Boss.
Thank you, sir.
Sure don't want half this?
What is it?
It's a Bob Cousy sandwich. It's mostly tongue.
Vegetarian.
Still?
That's the thing about life choices. You tend to make them for life.
Wow.
It's pretty. Who is she?
I don't know. Yet. Mmm. Oh, God, she's leaving her business card. I love when they do that.
Times have changed. In my day, if you didn't ask a girl to dance, she didn't dance.
Yep, well, nowadays they do a lot more than dance.
Uh-huh.
Hey, what are you supposed to do? You know, a woman throws herself at you and you gotta catch her, right?
Hmm.
What if you're not interested in the pitch?
Well, who wouldn't be?
Well, hypothetically, what if I thought Mrs. Blake was making up reasons to come see me at the clinic?
What, you think she's coming on to you?
Well, I don't know. But what grown woman has turtle trouble?
Well, there is one way to find out. A woman who is interested in you is always going to laugh too loudly at your jokes. Does Mrs. Blake do that?
I hadn't noticed.
We'll do a test. Have you told her that stupid duck joke yet?
I love that joke. That's not stupid.
Trust me. Thanks. To anyone who's not coming on to this.
Oh. Okay, we're gonna start now.
Is he okay?
Yeah, the betadine's just a little cold. You're gonna be hearing a few cries, but the whole procedure will be over shortly.
Can you slide this stylet in?
Okay, and...
Did you feel the pop?
Yeah. Nothing.
Try rotating the bevel.
Still nothing. Something wrong?
No. It just takes a few seconds to find.
Are you midline? Yes. I'm just not getting any fluid out.
My baby. Oh, God. She's hurting my baby's spine.
Are you sure you know what
Sid,
you're doing?
Do you want me to take over?
All right, hon. Just do it.
Oh, I don't believe this. Of all the stupid and what, so now she's gonna do it?
Mr. Kosowski, stand back. We are in the middle of a procedure.
Oh, dear God, please don't let anything happen to my baby.
Please go. You ready to go?
Yeah.
All right. Ready?
Okay.
Did you get it?
Give me a sec. Got it.
Oh, thank God. Oh, thank God. Well done.
It's a team effort.
I heard a noise. I see a mess. What's going on?
Oh, I'm looking for a baby care book that Mom bought me, but then she went and died without telling me where she put it.
How thoughtless.
Hi.
Oh, hi, sweetie. A package came for you.
Aren't you even gonna ask how Hannah is?
Of course. How's Hannah?
I'm not talking to you.
Here you go.
Thanks, Dad. Hey, listen, Daddy, I need to take a nap, so can you please make sure you wake me up in 20 minutes?
Sure.
Thanks.
I have got to cut down.
Hey, Mom. What's up?
Since you and your sister aren't talking, I thought you might want to chat. I hear you're having dinner with Jerry tonight.
Is this what you're wearing?
Never heard of her.
Dead and still checking labels. Jerry bought it for me and I'm not wearing it.
Of course you are. That would appear rude and ungrateful, and you're neither.
I used to dress up like that all the time when I lived in L.A.
You had quite the life there, didn't you? Celebrity clients, convertible Porsche, house overlooking the ocean. And now you overlook the Schwager's backyard.
What are you trying to say? That I made the wrong decision moving here?
No, I'm just saying you made the decision while still reeling from the loss of dear departed moi. Now in a more rational light, it seems healthy to question that choice.
There were some great things about L.A. The weather.
The weather?
Admit it, you had fun there. Providence can't compete with Hollywood for glamour and excitement.
Well, that's true. Although Providence does have its charms.
You mean Kyle?
He said he had something important to tell me. Any idea what it is?
Maybe high school fantasy boy wants to ask you to go steady.
Sometimes I worry that I'll never be happy here. That I'll always feel like I'm living between two worlds.
Tell me about it.
Hello. Oh, Jerry. No, I was reading. I don't need a ride. I'll meet you there. Okay, bye.
Bye. Driver, change of plans. We can go straight to the River Club.
Sure thing. Nice restaurant. Big date?
She doesn't think it is. Hey, can I ask you a question?
You just did. Go ahead, ask me another one.
You think couples can still be friends even after they break up?
I'd say theoretically, yes. But practically, no.
Why do relationships have to be on or off? Why can't they just have a dimmer switch?
Because that is not the way women work. Although, I don't know your ex.
Oh, she's great. She's one of the few people in my life I've been almost honest with. But I messed up and she moved back to Providence. I'm trying to convince her that was a mistake. I feel guilty thinking that she chucked her whole life just because of me.
Well, then make your case. What do you got to lose?
Nothing.
Well, then go for it. And good luck, man.
Thanks. Man.
Breathtaking.
Thank you.
Oh, that's my phone. It's been going nuts. I have a new client who has a script. It's about an alien who loses his luggage and it winds up on Earth. Everybody wants it. But they're just gonna have to wait. Do you wanna know why?
Sure, why?
Because tonight, I only have ears for you. And to show you that I mean it, power off. Power off. Beeper off.
Jerry, I'm touched.
So, tell me about your day. How was your spinal tap? See? I was paying attention.
I wish you hadn't been. It didn't go very well.
Oh. Did you lose the patient?
Oh, no. The test came back normal. We gave the baby a big shot of antibiotics and sent him home.
And what's so bad about it?
I couldn't find the spinal canal. The baby was screaming. Parents hated me, and someone else had to finish the job. But other than that, it was just perfect.
Oh, Sid. I'm sorry. And I'm also surprised.
Surprised?
Before coming to Providence, you were the most confident doctor I ever met.
Well, coming home wasn't exactly as easy as I thought it would be.
Then why don't you come back?
Because I want to do something more meaningful, Jerry.
Okay. Meaningful is doing something that you're good at, something that you enjoy, and something that you are uniquely qualified to do. Now, do you feel like that at the clinic?
Not always. I'll admit that days like today, I wish I were doing what I was trained for.
I bet you could get your old job back.
They already have another partner.
Yeah, but they hate him. His noses are too 1980. Look, Phil told me so himself.
You talked to Phil?
Mm-hmm, and he would love to talk to you. In fact, I already set it up.
Are you kidding?
Look, I swear, I shut mine off.
I know, it's mine. Hello? Helen? Oh, no.
What?
Yeah, I'll get over there right away. I'll call you later. Thanks. The Kosowski baby had a febrile seizure. I've got to get over to the hospital. We're admitting him.
Sydney, think about what I said.
Yeah. Thanks. Got it. 130. How's he doing?
Get away.
Excuse me?
We are done with you.
Wait a minute. Wait, Mr. Kosowski. I'd like to accompany my patient into the hospital.
I said get lost.
She's just trying to help.
Look, we don't need her help. I mean it. She's useless.
I'll be back soon.
Dr. Anthony?
Yes.
The front desk told me that you were admitting the Kosowski baby. I'm Sid Hansen. Dr. Sid Hansen. I was taking care of Christopher at the clinic. I'd like to be a part of the diagnostic team.
Well, you're not on staff.
I realize that. I thought that we could arrange something informal.
Well, it sounds like the parents are not all that happy about the treatment they got at the clinic.
Okay, I clashed a little with the father, but I'd still like to help the child.
Is your specialty pediatrics?
Actually, plastic and reconstructive surgery.
I see. Well, thank you for your offer, but I think we can take it from here.
Hello.
Hi.
Thank you so much, Doctor. I wasn't sure I'd catch you in on a Friday night, but I guess I got lucky.
Well, I normally don't do house calls, but you sounded so desperate.
I wouldn't say I was desperate.
About your dog.
Oh, no, of course. Oh, of course. Of course. Poor Kobe. He threw up a big, bloody red mess of something on the floor, and I was afraid he might have ruptured something.
Is it still?
Yes. Be my guest. It's right through that door in the kitchen.
You have a beautiful house, Mrs. Blake.
Oh, please. Cynthia.
Cynthia?
Yes, thank you. It's a little large for one person. But the animals helped to fill it up a little. Did you find the sick sick?
Yes, I think I know what's caused Kobe's stomach problem.
Oh, is it serious?
No, it's lasagna.
No! Mm-hmm. No, that's what I had for dinner tonight.
So did Kobe.
Oh, no.
And I think it was tomato sauce, not blood. Now that it's out of his system, he'll be fine.
Oh, well, is that it? I mean, you must think I'm a complete idiot.
Of course I don't. No harm done. If Kobe has any more problems, just give me a call.
Doctor, may I call you Jim?
Sure.
I was... I just wondered...
I heard a joke the other day.
A joke?
A duck goes into a drugstore to buy some chapstick. And the clerk says, will that be cash or charge? And the duck says, just put it on my bill.
On his bill, it's so cute.
You're very sweet.
my gym.
How long has it been since your husband passed away?
4 years.
It's a long time.
Yeah. It's too long.
Yeah, I understand. But, it's only been a couple of months since Linda...
You're not ready yet.
No, I'm not.
I'm so embarrassed.
Oh, don't be. I'm flattered.
Thank you.
Dr. Anthony, could you please make sure he gets it?
Yes, of course.
Thank you.
Dr. Hansen, what are you doing here?
I just wanted to make sure that Christopher's files were faxed over.
I was in the chapel. Praying. They want to do exploratory surgery tomorrow.
I think that makes sense.
Nothing makes sense. I mean, Doug and I are Catholics, and I believe that whatever happens, happens because of him. But... why would he do this to a little baby? My grandmother gave me this Bible, and she said that all the answers in the whole world were in it. And I've been reading the book of Job over and over, but it doesn't say anything about exploratory surgery.
Lori? Yeah, Chris just woke up. He seems hungry.
I'll be right there.
Okay.
I better go. Will you come by and check on Chris?
I don't think your husband would like that very much.
Well, here. Say I left my Bible in the chapel and you found it. You can bring it by tomorrow when you come visit.
Oh, good, you're here. Joni called me at the bar in a total panic, made me come down here and look at Hannah's rash.
Well, what do you know about rashes?
More than I'd like. Listen, we looked through your medical books. It doesn't look like diphtheria, so I'm heading out. Hey.
Mommy.
Kyle.
Hey. You okay to talk now?
Can it wait?
Sorry, Sid. I really can't put this off anymore. My old manager in Pawtucket called last night to say that the Portland Sea Dogs are looking for an assistant coach, and the job is mine if I want it.
Wow. That's a wonderful opportunity, isn't it?
Yeah. Managing a minor league team has always been a dream of mine. Problem is, I'd have to move to Maine.
Oh. I see.
It was an easy call a month ago, but now that we've sort of started seeing each other...
Kyle, I wouldn't want you to miss out on such a great opportunity.
Well, I wouldn't mind, really, if I knew that we were beginning something, you know, sort of long-term.
I guess we don't know that yet, do we?
Well, right now, we don't even know if we have chemistry.
Chemistry? I mean, you don't think we do?
Well, who knows? I mean, we haven't even kissed.
Oh, my God, you're right.
Closest we came is CPR. Look, I know this sounds stupid, all right, but with the Sea Dog offer on the table... I was wondering if we could, you know.
You mean you want to?
Oh, no, not that. Not right away. I mean, we could after, but I think we should just start off with a kiss.
No? Are you here?
Too weird, huh?
Oh, no, your career's on the line, Kyle. Come here. Come here.
I really appreciate this. Are you gonna close your eyes?
Oh, yeah. What do you think?
Can we go again?
So This is a really great opportunity, right?
Yeah, with a major benefit package, full dental, pension plan in the works.
Kyle, I'm gonna miss you.
I'll miss you too, Sid.
Hannah had a rash. You want me to take a look at it?
If you want. It's on her chest.
No, it's just a little prickly heat. I wouldn't worry about it.
I know you wouldn't.
Don't start, Joni. I've had a horrible day. Good night.
I wish Mom were here.
Why?
Well, for one thing, so I could complain about you. For another, at least she knew what to do about a sick baby.
What, Joni? What? Do you want me to run a series of tests on 10 dots?
No. I want you to be sympathetic. Because when your baby is sick, even just a little, it is the most horrible feeling in the world, and Mom would have understood that. I was hoping you could fill in for her, but you have no idea what it's like.
Oh, you're so right. I don't know what it's like. I don't know anything. You know, I am useless at the clinic. I am useless at home. You don't want me. My fantasy life with Kyle is completely over. I'm going back to LA. Why is it the one time I need Robbie to be here to show me where he put my suitcases? He's not.
Maybe it's a sign you shouldn't go.
It's just a few days, Dad. I want to see if my old job is still available, and then I'll know what my options are.
How can you just run out on the clinic? What are they going to do?
Well, it's not like they weren't shorthanded when I got here. They'll be shorthanded when I leave. I didn't take anybody's job.
Oh, Sid, I can't believe you're going to
say Daddy, not now, okay? I got to meet Jerry at 1 o'clock. Before that, I got to check on a patient, an ex-patient.
An ex-patient you care so much about your leave?
Dad, it's a long story, okay? These are my suitcases. Oh my God.
Good morning, Hannah, Bonanna, Shoshana, Sultana, Cookana.
Joni, before you say anything sarcastic, look what I found.
Mom's handwriting. Where'd you find these?
Up in the attic.
Do you want to hear the card?
Yeah.
Dear Joni, read this. He knows almost as much as I do.
That sounds like Mom.
Dr. Spock. This one doesn't have a card.
Maybe it's for the baby.
You're right. Oh, the Runaway Bunny.
I love that book.
Once there was a little bunny who wanted to run away. So he said to his mother, I am running away. If you run away, said his mother, I will run after you. For you are my little bunny. Oh, I miss her so much, Sid. I can't believe she's never gonna meet Hannah. Oh, gosh, you really would have loved her, huh? I can't believe she's never going to be a part of her life.
Don't say that. That's not true. I mean, Mom's genes are in Hannah. Right? I mean, I know that's not as great as having a grandmother who can play with her and read to her.
but don't ever say that Mom's not a part of her because she already is. Can't escape your DNA.
Problem. What's that about?
I think I have a breakthrough on the Kosowski baby case. What if it is genetic disease?
Well, I thought we ruled out the major ones.
Yeah, well, look at these. High prevalence of breech presentation, difficult feeding, puffy hands, weak or absent suck.
Familial dysautonomia. I never heard of it.
Yeah, me neither.
According to this, both parents must be descendants of Ashkenazi Jews. The Kosowskis don't fit that profile.
But the symptoms fit Christopher. And you can't escape your DNA.
Did the doctor say how long the surgery would take?
It depends on what they find. What are you doing here?
I know I'm the last person you want to see, but I think I might know what's wrong with Christopher. When Lori said all the answers are in her grandmother's Bible, she may have been right.
What are you talking about?
Just listen to her, Doug.
It's a long shot, but Christopher's symptoms indicate that he could have a disorder called familial dysautonomia. Once detected, it's fairly easily treated, but it's found in a certain genetic group. So I have to ask you this question. Are you two by any chance Jewish?
What?
I know that it's not the religion that you practice, but I noticed that there was a Star of David in Lori's Bible, and it occurred to me that perhaps your ancestors might have been Ashkenazi Jews. I'm asking because I want to prevent unnecessary surgery for Christopher.
I was raised Jewish. I converted to Catholicism after I met Doug. But his family's been Catholic for generations.
Yeah, I don't know about my father's parents. You know, I never met them. But you can't get much more Catholic than my mom's parents. I mean, they were raised by nuns in Poland.
When was that?
30s, 40s.
That's the time that a lot of Jewish children were raised outside the family for their own protection.
Yeah, but it still doesn't fit. I mean, my grandmother never missed a day of church.
I'm not doubting your ancestors' beliefs, just their genetic makeup. Now there's a test that can tell us if Christopher has this disorder or not. But I don't want to delay the surgery unless you feel that there's a chance he might be part of this risk group.
All right, do the test.
Great. I'll tell Dr. Anthony. Oh, excuse me.
Okay.
Hello? Jerry. Oh my God, I totally forgot.
Hey, come on, we got a plane to catch. Where's your luggage?
I don't have any.
That's okay, we'll buy you new clothes when we get to LA.
Jerry, we need to talk.
Can't we talk in the limo?
No, I'm not going to LA.
What do you mean?
Well, there's been a change of plans. I'm staying here in Providence.
Oh, jeez. How come?
Providence?
Great. So what do I do now?
You go. I don't want you to miss your plane. You belong in L.A.
So do you.
Not anymore. It's beautiful. It just doesn't feel real.
I know. That's what I love about it. Well, I better go. If you ever change your mind, I hope you call me. I'll come rescue you.
Hey, man, let's get to the airport.
Thought we were picking someone up.
You are not gonna believe this. I just lost the girl of my dreams.
Welcome to the club.
You know what? If
think I'd rather sit up front with you and talk.
Fine with me. Don't touch the radio.
Dr. Hansen, got the results.
And?
You were right.
Familial dysautonomia.
That was an incredible call.
Have you told the Kosowskis?
Not yet. I thought you deserved to do that.
Thanks. We've contacted the FD Treatment Center in New York. They want to see you as soon as possible.
Will you put Christopher on drugs?
From what I've read, FD is mostly treated with special therapies for feeding and respiratory care. But they'll know more than I do.
Can we call you after the New York trip? We'd like to keep you involved.
Are you sure?
Yeah, as much as you want. You know, I keep thinking about what you said, how babies can't give us information. Well, I've learned quite a bit about myself from Christopher today.
He's a pretty amazing little guy.
We owe you so much for not giving up on this case. But the way I treated you, you should have.
Well, it's a little problem I have. I don't give up easily. If you had known my mother, you'd understand. Persistence is in my genes.
Sweetie, are you sure you don't want to go to the movies? I'll be happy to stay home and take care of Hannah.
I'm absolutely sure, Dad. I'm wiped out. I'm probably going to go to bed as soon as you guys leave.
Sure.
Okay, Hannah's asleep. Sid, will you check on her in a few minutes?
Ew. No problem.
Come on, let's go. What are we waiting for?
Bye.
See ya.
Drink, said the little bunny. I will become a little sailboat, and I will sail away from you.
If you become a sailboat, said the mother,
and sail away from me, I will become the wind and blow.
What are you looking at?
The way things should have been.
Well, you can't live the should-haves. Life is full of surprises. Some pleasant, some not so pleasant. You really shouldn't have to taste the carpet at your daughter's wedding.
I'm sorry, Mom. But if it makes you feel any better, I'll tell Hannah lots of stories about you when she gets older.
Tell her I was a great dancer. I always wanted to be a great dancer. Oh, and say I played the piano. No, the saxophone. That sounds hipper. Mm. And can you make me tall?
Good night, Mother.
And a natural blonde.
In a meeting.